Books, outdoors and active scenario. You work for Outdoors and Active, a company making outdoor equipment. It has three divisions: tents, outdoor clothing, sleeping bags. The accounting system tracks the costs and revenue and money invested in each of these divisions separately. The finance director would like you to produce a report for the company showing each division's performance in the following order: revenue, costs, individual and total. Profit earned and profit as percentage of revenue. Investment made and the return on investment expressed as percentage. He is considering moving away from reporting simply a profit centre basis, so would like to see how each division performs as a revenue centre, cost centre, profit centre and investment centre. The information for each of the divisions for the year ended 31st March is set out below. So we've got our three divisions: tents, outdoor clothing, sleeping bags, our costs, material, labour and overheads, and the money, revenue and money invested. We've been asked to open a new spreadsheet and name it Outdoors, divisional 31st of March. So I'm just going to go File, Save As, call it what I need to call it. It says, set up a suitable heading in A1 and A2 to indicate the company and the reporting period and format it in bold. As I like to have my instructions on the left, spreadsheet on the right, I'm going to go new in view and then view, arrange all vertical. So here I can click on the spreadsheet and here I can read the instructions. Suitable heading in A1. So, suitable heading is the company name. It says performance 31st March 2001, so year ended. And I want it in bold, so I'm going to highlight Control B. Okay. Says name the worksheet divisional performance. At the moment it's sheet 1, so I'm going to right click or double click and I'm going to call it divisional and when you're done press enter to make sure it takes. Produce a report showing the relevant information in order to indicate it by the finance director. So revenue 0, 5, 6, 3, 0, 3, 6, 8, 0. Okay, costs, material, labour, overhead. Profit earned, I think, investment. All right, so I've entered in my information and now I need to work out my costs. So revenue's already done, total cost I need to work out. So I'm going to go formula. And I'm going to add up all my total cost by using AutoSum. Check it on your calculator. If it's correct, I can replicate across. Profit earned will be my revenue minus my total cost. So I'm going to go open bracket, revenue minus total cost, close bracket. And if I'm happy with that, replicate across. Profit will be percentage, so I'm going to go equals open brackets. I'm going to say profit earned divided by my revenue, close bracket. I'm happy with that, replicate across. And then I've got to do return on investment. The return on investment will be equals open bracket investment will be profit earned divided by my investment made, close brackets. And I need that to be a percentage, which it is. Excellent. Right. It's now saying use borders to define each responsibility center. So revenue would be one. And I need to put top and bottom border. Costs would be another. Profit earned will be another. And investment would be another. All right. Format figures to show no decimal places with a thousand separator. So I'm going to highlight my data, right click, format cells. I'm going to go zero decimal places, thousand separator. And OK to that. It says include the additional percentages as required using formulas to calculate and format them as one decimal place. So I'm going to right click, format cells. Percentage, one decimal place. Right click, format cells, percentage, one decimal place. Use cell fill with one chosen color to highlight the highest revenue. So highlight which one's the highest, this one. So I'm going to highlight that in green. Profit as a percentage, revenue, profit, just this one. Use cell fill with one chosen color to highlight the highest revenue, done. Highest cost, which is this one. Profit as a percentage, that one. And return on investment. And then save your worksheet. This chapter is now done.